Batteries. Blackbird batteries. More batteries. All batteries. If you have questions about how to maintain your battery for your electric bike, I have answers. If you're wondering how many cycles you can get out of a lithium battery for an electric bike, if you want to know what you should do with your e-bike battery in cold temperatures, if you want to know what percentage you should charge your e-bike battery up to, and if you have questions about how to keep your battery properly balanced, and finally, what should you do if you need to store your battery for a prolonged period of time?
This is Jeopardy!
Before we get into specifics, I have to thank today's sponsor for the video, me. But seriously though, there is no sponsor for the video other than Bolton e-bikes and just trying to get more information and knowledge out there about electric bikes. However, if you like this content, you want to see more, click that join button below this video. You get exclusive access to an extra video every month that has more behind the scenes details on what we're working on and new projects. You can get a little loyalty badge next to your name, and you also get to do things like vote on thumbnails for future videos before they're released to everyone else. And when we release new models, I do want your help as members of the channel to name them. So if you want access to those extra things on this YouTube channel, you can click that join button. If you don't want to do that, that's totally fine. You can stick around, watch a weekly video from me for free. And
for free.
Maintaining e-bike batteries is not hard. In fact, in my opinion, they are the easiest. Often when people think about battery maintenance, they're thinking of lead acid batteries. You have liquid that you're having to replace and
around batteries, it's always important to wear proper personal protective equipment. Eye protection, appropriate level of water to each cell, making sure that the final electrolyte level is 1/8 of an inch below the bottom of the vent well.
When I was a kid, I actually got battery acid in my eyes. Turns out eyes heal quickly, who knew? Sometimes you have to put a maintainer on the battery, basically a special charger to keep things topped off, but lithium batteries are so much easier. Now that being said, I still wanna make sure you get the absolute most you can out of your e-bike battery. Tip number one is don't discharge a lithium battery completely. With lead acid, that is okay. With nickel metal hydride or NiCad or different other older formats, some of them actually recommended a full discharge for certain reasons. But with lithium batteries, that is a big no. You do not want to fully discharge the cells to zero. And if you do that, you'll be fine. That's probably all you really need to know. Okay, I'm just kidding. There's actually more than that. But that is the first tip. Don't discharge down to zero voltage. That's basically unrecoverable and not good. Now, does that mean that you can't go for a ride on your e-bike until the battery dies and shuts off? Well, no, it doesn't actually, because every battery has something inside that is called a BMS. I feel like this is some sort of mystery device that no one gets to see, so let's go find one. This is probably what you think an e-bike battery looks like, but this is just an outer shell or plastic case, and ta-da, there's nothing in there because it's already out. This is what it looks like on the inside. This is a BMS, or battery management system. It's basically a smart little circuit board, and you have outputs that are going to the terminals, which would connect to your cradle. You can see there's little wires going all over the place. BMS is monitoring the voltage of individual cells. So to put this simply, this battery knows not just when this cell gets down or up to a certain voltage. It also knows when this one goes to a certain voltage or this one. It's looking at a collection or a group of the cells. The battery management system will actually cut off the battery when the voltage gets down to a certain point to prevent your battery from getting damaged. So when you take your e-bike for a ride and you drain the battery until the bars on your display go down to nothing, and at some point the whole bike just shuts off, the voltage on your bike is actually not at zero or anywhere close to it. The cells actually have a fair amount of voltage left, but that's where they need to be cut off for longevity. If you drained them down to zero, like I said, they'd be unrecoverable. Now, do I recommend doing that, kind of running it all the way to the minimum? No, I probably wouldn't do that on a regular basis, but that's what the BMS is for. Often a question is, how many cycles will they get? And a little bit of confusion is caused sometimes when I talk about a cycle, and what does that actually mean? And basically, that is a full discharge and charge cycle. So if you're starting with the battery at 100% capacity, and you drain it down to where that BMS effectively cuts the voltage off, that is a full discharge cycle. Now, I've seen different numbers thrown around.
S equals 1/2 AT squared, where S is the altitude, A is the gravity constant of 32, and T is the time it took for that rock to come back down.
But usually somewhere between 800 and 1,000 cycles is what these individual cells are rated for. I've seen some people say as low as 500. If you say go ride your bike for 20 miles on a full discharge cycle, and you could do that 1,000 times, that would be 20,000 miles. That's a lot of mileage on an e-bike. If you only get half of that, you know, 500 cycles, then obviously that's going to be half. That'd still be about 10,000 miles before you wear your e-bike battery out. And I want to be clear that if you go from, say, 100% down to half of your battery capacity, instead of draining it all the way to zero, that is effectively only half of a discharge cycle. Now, when we get into charging, this is where there's a lot of interesting information about charge percentages. Most e-bike chargers that come with your electric bike are going to charge to 100% every single time. And that's okay. I don't want anyone to think like they're killing their battery by charging to 100%. Those cycle ranges I just gave you are normal expectations. If you are charging to 100%, you want the most range you can get out of your battery. If you want to extend the overall lifespan of your battery, you can charge to slightly less than full capacity. And there's good and bad things about that. Let me explain the good first. If you charge to 90%, that's effectively going to be easier on the internal components of those cells. They will actually last longer, as in, instead of 800 cycles, maybe if you go to 90%, you'll get 1,000 cycles. Some studies suggest that maybe at 80% charge, you might get double the number of cycles before that battery dies. Personally, I always charge my e-bike to 100%. Do I know that in theory it might last longer at 90%? Yes, it might. But I know that I'm gonna lose 10% range every time if I don't charge it fully, and you know, it's a trade-off. Now, what is the downside? I think this is something that's often overlooked, and that has to do with balancing. So we're jumping back to that BMS. When the lowest of the lowest cells goes down to a certain cutoff point, it's gonna shut your battery off. And also when the highest gets to a highest point, it's gonna turn off the charging function. So it protects the cells from being charged to too high of a voltage and potentially blowing up.
As you can see, that's a great way to, that a house fire has started, right? Like that.
Definitely don't want that. Most of the BMSs used on the market require the battery to be at 100% to balance the cells. And what they're doing is basically allowing each cell to be charged up to a certain point and then stop. If you don't charge to 100%, Some of those are not capable of balancing the cells. Some will get lower, some will get higher, and your battery's not gonna perform as well and may die prematurely. You may not get as much range out of it. So even if you do charge to 80 or 90% increase the overall life expectancy, it's a good idea to still charge to 100% on occasion to make sure that the cells are balanced. Now, what about storage? And I'm not talking about putting your batteries on a shelf and where do you physically put them.
340?
I mean, if this guy's got this kind of energy and this kind of artistic eye, I wanna see what else he's got.
What is the best percent of charge or voltage to store your battery? Different voltages will actually cause different things to happen within the battery. Now, typically most batteries will slowly drain or lose voltage over time. So you really do not want to leave your battery dead for weeks or months. You may go plug your battery in and nothing happens. It doesn't want to charge because the cells have gradually dipped below the lowest safe voltage to charge. The BMS is not gonna allow those cells to charge. Your battery is toast. Now, if it's gonna be a few days, maybe even a few weeks, charging to 100% and leaving the battery that way is just fine. Let's say you live in an area where it snows really heavily in the winter and you don't feel like riding out in the cold, and you know you're not gonna ride for 2 or 3 months. The best storage number that I've seen based on lithium ion cell studies shows to be around 70%. Now, you could charge the battery up to around that 70%. You could look at the voltage on your display or some other number to kind of gauge if you might be in that ballpark. Or you could charge your battery up to 100%, go for a 5-mile ride around the neighborhood to bring it down a little bit. Now, do batteries like being left out in the cold? The answer to that would be no. If you left your e-bike outside or in the garage and the temperature is freezing or below, do not charge your battery. They really, really don't like it. And unfortunately, you can cause permanent damage. It's better to take your battery inside. Oops. Bring your battery inside, let it warm up to room temperature, and it will be much, much happier. Now for just charging, that's a little bit different. It's okay to start with your battery at room temperature, take your bike from inside and go on a cold ride outside. What you may notice if it's really cold is a loss in performance, meaning your battery won't produce quite as much power. The bike might feel a little sluggish. It may not have the same amount of range. If you know you're gonna be out for a while, I would recommend insulating the battery in some way. I've seen people design custom sleeves that go around them. I've seen people put their batteries in a triangle bag in the frame. Anything you can do to keep it a little bit warmer in freezing temperatures is only going to help not only the performance, but the overall longevity of the battery. Do you have squeaky brakes? Do you not stop on time? Are you looking for more performance? Then go check out this video for an easy way to upgrade your stock mechanical disc brakes to something with better performance.